So it's currently 2:35 p.m. on a Tuesday afternoon, December 1st, 2017. I'm about to head off to the post office, but I wanted to say I just had a panic attack about 5-10 minutes ago. I don't want to get into too much details, but let's just say I felt like I was going to lose it. Not like lose control, but I felt like something was going to happen. Well, you know, every time you have a panic attack, you think you're going to die. But this panic attack, it's one that I never felt. I haven't felt in a long time, which, you know, you get jumpy when you have a panic attack. But you get even jumpier when you have a panic attack that felt different from the other panic attacks. I can't speak for everyone else, but sometimes my panic attacks doesn't feel the same. This one, my head just went numb. I had this burning sensation, like my skin was crawling under me. You know, it just felt like I was gonna have a stroke. That's all I can really say. I mean, I don't know what a stroke feels like, but my head just went numb. My head was just doing some strange tingling then. But other than that, yeah, I don't want to really talk about it too much, but, you know, that's how I felt. However, I'm still going to go for this drive to the post office, and, you know, I'm still going to go for a walk with my neighbor later on in the afternoon. Other than that, I'm just going to switch over to the GoPro and start driving. So my GoPro, memory card just got full, so I couldn't record off my GoPro. I just dropped off the mail just around the corner from the post office. I'm still feeling the effects of my panic attack from earlier. But I'm still here. You know, I feel a little panicky. I'm not that far from home, but I'm about to head home right now. My body's completely tensed up, and I'm a little dizzy right now. But like I said, I'm here. I'm in the car by myself. I didn't ask my daughter to go with me, because I knew I'll be okay. Even though I feel so strange, I'm gonna be okay. You know, sometimes you just have to know that no matter how bad it feels like, you know, you're gonna have to remind yourself that after the panic feeling goes away, you're okay. Like right now, I can tell my breathing is off. You can probably see it from the way I'm talking, and I'm getting a burning sensation on my body. You know, if just the burning feeling, a little, also it feels like something, my skin is like itchy and stuff too. Other than that, yeah, I'm about to head back home. And just continue with my day. I'm still gonna go for a walk later with my neighbor. Maybe I'll try to record some of it, but we'll see. Other than that, you know, yeah, you can tell that I'm kind of out of it right now, but, you know, that's how panic attacks are. You feel strange, it feels scary for that moment, and once you calm down, you start to think like, okay, what was that about? But, you know, what can you do? You know, just gotta keep as calm as you can and continue. I mean, yesterday, you know, I had a great day, even though like I had little moments of panic, but I was still able to go out and, you know, do what I wanted to do. You know, I'm gonna try my best not to let this beat me. Sure, there are days that, you know, it's gonna feel like it's impossible to get over it, but you just have to try every day and just continue. That's what I'm doing right now. Anyways, I'm just gonna head home right now. That burning and sensation is kind of annoying. It's, you know, if you never had it before, you won't kind of understand, but it also feels like your skin feels completely itchy at the same time. It's the burning and the itchy, and it feels like a bunch of little fire ants. I mean, I don't know what fire ants feels like, but it feels like a bunch of little insects just like crawling over your body, and you're just getting itchy and burning. That's how I feel right now. But other than that, yeah, I'm about to head home and see how it goes. So as you can see, I just went inside the inside Dick's Sporting Goods. Yeah, I didn't think I was gonna go in, but I went in anyway. So, like I mentioned, I'm by myself. I didn't go with my daughter. I was just gonna go home from the post office after, but you know, I wanted to go in and prove to myself that, you know, even though I had a panic attack, I feel strange, I thought I was gonna have a stroke, I'm gonna go inside the store anyways, you know. I say, so what? So what about my panic attack? I'm just gonna go inside the Dick's Sporting Goods. I'm only about a little bit over 5 minutes away from my house, but I still went in and I feel good about it. You know, whenever you have that moment where you feel like you can't do something, go prove to yourself that you can do it. And every time you do it, it gets easier and easier. See, like I proved to myself that I can go in, even though I was just coming down from a panic attack, and I'm happy. My breathing got better. My panic is going away because I proved it to my panic attack that I'm not scared. But you know, they just opened this door sometime last year, and I wanted to go inside last year, but I never made it because I've been inside this Dick's Sporting Goods at a different location before I had panic attacks. So you know, when they opened one here, I wanted to go in, but you know, my anxiety was kept me from going in. So I got a chance to finally go in, and that's another place that I can cross off my bucket list. But yeah, now I'm heading home.